Some of them. The old times. Oh, yeah. Yeah, everybody.
Thank you. On behalf of the Board of Education, the administration, faculty, and staff of Cuba Rushford School, I would like to welcome you to here tonight. What a special night.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I would like to begin by welcoming all our parents, grandparents, family members, faculty, staff, and administrators to the 2021 Cuba Rushford graduation ceremony. I have been honored to serve as the school board president this past year, and I'm equally honored to be speaking to all of you tonight during the celebration of the milestone reached by the students of the class of 2021. The Board of Education would also like to thank all the upcoming retirees at the very best. And if it wasn't for all your involvement into this district, we would not be where we are today. Thank you. Now, for the class of 2021, I've heard a little rumor that you've been called the experimental class. Why is that? Well, let's take a little walk down memory lane. You guys realize you're the first class that had to take on the full experiment of the Common Core, dealing with flipped classrooms, new teachers, their new teaching styles, the new regulations for Regents exams, the integration of technology every year, the new apps, the new platforms, and going from classroom teaching to Zoom learning for a year and a half for something called the world pandemic. And lastly, just trying to live your teenage lives. Wow. That's a lot to take in, isn't it? All the years you guys been here. Well, just to let you know, the Board of Education does not see the class of 2021 as an experimental class, but a resilient class, a nimble class, a class with a unique life experience. Matter of fact, no one that other class in Cuba Rushford history has ever seen. So the only advice the board can give to say right now is stay involved, volunteer, and pass on what you have learned, because we can learn a lot from your experience from the last 18 years. So on behalf of the Board of Education and the Cuba Rushford School community, we are so very proud of you and all your accomplishments. We will always be here for you whenever you need us. Keep up the great work, congratulations, and welcome to the family of CRCS alumni.
And other listeners checking the clock and waiting to get on with it. Before I move forward though, I just wanted to take a moment to thank a few of the people and groups who helped every member of the class of 21 get where we are today. To the Cuba Rushford administration and teachers, we thank you for creating an environment rich in learning where no student will be left behind. To the cafeteria, maintenance, and transportation team, we thank you for being the backbone that keeps the school running and for providing an endless amount of chicken patties. Lastly, and more personally, I thank my parents for creating an atmosphere where I feel I can be myself and pursue my passions. To have unwavering support is more encouraging than anything, so really, there is no one else I'd rather have as my number one fan. To my peers, I think it's safe to say that we have been through a lot in the class of 2021. Throughout high school, we have dealt with constant construction and administration change, a global pandemic, Zoom classrooms, and, maybe worst of all, Mr. Stubbs in the classroom. Twice. As we move toward the next step in our lives, may we always remember the times we shared Super Retro. Although taking on a plethora of forms, our rebel mascot has the power to represent many of the characteristics we should all embody in both the present and future. No longer a figure rooted in a racist past, our rebel should be a change maker, a strong leader, a fighter for the greater good. By graduating with such traits, we all have the responsibility to still be a rebel in our communities, wherever that may be. Optimistically, our world is changing for the better. Although we may be leaving the high school classroom, we still have so much to learn about societal and cultural awareness outside of our small town. For many of us, that means altering the way in which we view and interact with the people around us to become a better ally. Our area lacks substantial racial diversity, which historically creates optimal conditions for negative stereotypes to propagate. Rebels are not afraid to fight for change, and as the next class of educated Americans, it is our social responsibility to expand our view outside of what we may limitedly think. By welcoming new voices and recognizing the struggles people of color face in our school, our town, our nation, we take a step forward in working towards a more inclusive environment. Racial equity is a systemic issue, but as rebels, we can still confront the necessary movement toward equal rights on an approachable scale. Additionally, rebels selflessly stand up for the improvement of a group as a whole. Whether it be the loss of a senior year, a job, or even a loved one, it's likely the pandemic affected each and every one of us in a negative way. While preventative measures and vaccines may safeguard the individual, they also protect a large group of those who are too young, immunocompromised, or fit other criteria that prevent them from being able to receive the vaccine.
Go ahead.
Public health should not be politicized, but our freedom of choice allows us to live in the back of our own accord. By following science and practicing empathy towards our peers, we all currently have that freedom to end these unprecedented times and prevent future coronavirus strains from ravaging our community once more. To my fellow rebels, I hope you choose to fight for the greater good of public safety so we can move past the pandemic restrictions and towards hopefully the best summer to date. Finally, rebels cannot begin to fight for positive change if they are simultaneously battling with their own mental health. Above all, we have a responsibility to ourselves to maintain a good personal safety. As we grow up, it is easy to be swept away in outward happenings, and whether we are ready or not, it's likely these next few years will be filled with change and uncertainty. Oftentimes, we tend to place academics, sports, work, or relationships above our own interests. Nobody is immune from sadness or anxiety, and standing here as a valedictorian, I would be lying to say I have never placed grades or extracurriculars above my personal well-being. Perfectionism is not only unrewarding, it's also not humanly possible. I hope every graduate here will remember to take care of yourself, because at the end of the day, you are your own best company. Although it feels as though graduating from Cuba Rushford means leaving the rebel mascot behind, the features of our figurehead must be remembered as we move forward. I am truly honored tonight to be graduating alongside a group of students I know are the changemakers of tomorrow. We grew up together, but if all good things must come to an end, this is the finale of a once-in-a-lifetime 12-year experience. Whether you are going to college, joining the military, or entering the workforce, I hope you remember to be rebels within your community and stand up for what is right. Our time at Cuba Rushford shaped us into the young adults we are today, and I can't overestimate how excited I am to see what our futures hold. Thank you, and go Rebels! I encourage you all to recognize how hard it's come, because even if our past minded to do weapons of hardship, they have also flourished with opportunity and growth. They say it takes 7 years for a friendship to last a lifetime. Cuba Rushford has welcomed me since my first day in fifth grade, and as of this year, it will be my 8th year as a CRCS student, and the 12th year belongs to my peers. Like a friendship, I believe we all have something from our time together as Cuba Rushford students that we will take with us for the rest of our lives. May it be friendships, life lessons, knowledge, or simply the memories. Cuba Rushford has given us many memories to look back on, from running through the halls during the walk-in, and to cheering high in the bleachers during our school pep rallies. Sixth grade gave us a trip to the sea. Niagara Falls. In seventh grade, we experienced history as we walked through the streets of Boston, and in eighth, we ventured to Washington, D.C. Ecology camp allowed us to learn and become familiar with our natural world. Again and again, we not only learned of our world, but were allowed to experience it and foster joy in our learning through these trips and events that CRCS offered us. Most of all, we recognize the simple experience of being a student, walking these halls, speaking with peers, sitting at lunch with friends, attending games or playing in them. You will never experience these events in the same way we do now. There are so many things about high school that I've taken advantage of, and only now, as I see all these wonderful things that I will never participate in again part to me, do I realize how important they are. Our experiences and time here, they are momentary, being like childhood. It's that simple fact that they will never be done again, which makes them so precious. And for all the teachers and staff that have given us patience and guidance, I cannot thank them enough. Has taken us in as children, as elementary schoolers, and has brought us through adolescence as middle and high schoolers. And now, we part from Cuba Rushford as soon-to-be adults, as prospective college students, and as those who will enter the workforce. In these halls, and in these classrooms, we've grown into who we are in this very moment. Today, it will perhaps be the last time I stand with all my peers. It will be the last day I come here as Cuba Rushford student, athlete, and club member, but I am proud. We now look back on our time here as Cuba Rushford graduates. It's 2021, it's been 12 years, and we've made it.
It is always a privilege to recognize the individuals who have worked so hard to connect with our children, help them discover their strengths, and give them the skills to succeed before they leave us. If you are here, I ask that you please stand when I read your name. I'd like to recognize our retirees, Wendy Sprague, Billy Stelrek, Jean Reese, and Stephanie Canfield, and Shannon Albert. Years, I wish you well in retirement. We also have one of our administrative team members retiring this year. He has been with us for 14 years, leading the elementary, loving our children, and giving them an amazing opportunity every single day. I know he has positively affected many of you here tonight. I want Mr. Erickson to stand, and a big thank you from all of us. This year we have four young men entering the armed forces. Gentlemen, when I call your name, please stand and remain standing. Families, please hold your applause until the end. Mr. Nathan Burdick joining the Army. Mr. Joshua Claus joining the Marines. Mr. Clint Griswold joining the Air Force. And Mr. Gabriel Horton joining the Navy. Awarded annually, the Cuba Council of Churches is pleased to fund a $500 one-time scholarship for a college-bound Cuba Rushford senior. The selected student shows evidence of a maturing relationship with Christ and best typifies commendable service in his or her local church and the community at large. This year, they had a singular entry. It is our pleasure to announce the winner of the 2021 scholarship, Mr. Joshua Ward.
Hunter Williams. The Allegheny County Pomona Grange Number 45 Inspiration Award, Sean Zeidler. The Allegheny County Grange Number 45 Perseverance Award, Clayton Burgesson. American Legion Citizenship Award, Hunter Williams. American Legion Citizenship Award Honorable Mention, Clint Griswold. Andrew Beck Memorial Scholarship, Ethan Bunk. Brenda Valet Memorial Scholarship, Caden Granger. Charles and Cecil Arsberger Memorial Award, Ethan Rick. Chet Sweer Memorial Visual Arts Award, Aiden Kamek. Cuba Rushford Alumni Association Scholarship, Caden Granger, Aliana Barnes. CRCS Student Council Leadership Award, Desiree Mintz. CRTA Education Award, Cole Harris. Cuba American Legion Auxiliary English 12 Award, Claire Benham. Cuba Chamber of Commerce Scholarship, Joshua Ward, Hunter Williams. Cuba Council of Churches, Joshua Ward. Cuba Grange Number 799 Agriculture Award, Brett Schaefer, Ethan Bunk, Trevor Hawley. Cuba Historical Society, Florence Wills Memorial History Award, Allie Barnes, Nathan Burdick. Cuba Lions Club Award for Nursing, Autumn Michalski. Cuba Lions Award for Tech and Vocational, Logan Barber. Cuba Rod and Gun Club Track Team Scholarship, Logan Barber. Cuba Rod and Gun Club Outdoor Enthusiast Scholarship, Hunter Williams. Cuba Rushford CTO Madeline A. Brown Math Award, Claire Benham. Cuba Friendship Masonic Lodge Number 306 Math 12 Award, Claire Benham, Haley Kump, Eric Ichahowski. Dale McGinnis Scholarship, Nathan Burdick, Ethan Ritz, Landon White. Revere Sweet Memorial Award, Ethan Ritz. Diane Winchell Gordon Memorial Award, Hunter Yonke. Donald and Jean Cotton, Dick and Paula Amundsen Memorial Scholarship, Logan Barber. French Club Service Award, Aiden Kamek. Ideal CRCS Student Award, Claire Benham, Hunter Williams. Jeffrey Linza Memorial Scholarship, Caden Granger. Jessica Karst Cauley Memorial Award, Leah Fender. Carl and Lois Barnard Awards, Jordan Alice, Ethan Bunk, Caden Granger. The L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship, Claire Benham, Jordan Beeman, Aiden Kamek, Aiden Kellogg, Aaron Kump, Desiree Mins, Lauren New, Adrian Weaver, Landon White, Hunter Williams. The Lawrence Dye Incorporated Scholarship, Jordan Alice, Lauren New. The Renee M. Granger Nicholas Memorial Award, Desiree Mins. Patriot Newspaper English 12 Composition Award, Leah Fuller. Patriot Newspaper Journalism Award, Landon White. PTO Scholarship, Adrian Weaver. Ralph Parbeck Memorial Scholarship, Hunter Williams. Renee Wolbert's Memorial Scholarship, Natalie Goble. Richard L. Reynolds Memorial Scholarship, Logan Barker. Robert Hull Memorial Music Award, Lauren Noon. Sydney and Janice Jean Funk Industrial Arts Award, Alex Walk Persia. Sons of the American Legion Award, Hunter Williams. Sons of the AMVETS Award, Nathan Burdick, Joshua Quaz. Stephen Holmes and Janet Holmes Red Eye Memorial Agriculture Award, Trevor Hawley. Town of Cuba Auxiliary Post 2721 VFW History 12 Award, Claire Benham and Haley Kump. Please join me in recognizing the scholarship recipients.
Officers and student council officers, when you hear your name, please stand and remain standing. Families, please hold your applause until the end. President Claire Benham, Treasurer Desiree Mins, Secretary Haley Kump, Student Council Leah Fuller, Aaron Kump, Haley Kump, Autumn Michalski, Desiree Mins, Hunter Williams. Thank you guys for all that you've done. Take a minute to recognize a couple of staff here. First class advisors, Mrs. Schaller and Mr. Zincoyette. Thank you everything for your work with the seniors this year. I know it was a little different with Zooms and 2 days and different days, so thank you very much. And also I wanted to take a moment to say to Jill Schwab, thank you for the senior celebration days. I think the kids loved it. The winter snow tubing. Paper is what I kind of gathered. And thank you to Sydney Neubauer. Prom was different this year, but it was a murder mystery. Apparently I did it, which we'll talk about later. But that was excellent. Okay, class of 2021. Life is about creating a story. And to the graduating class of 2021, you, my friends, have made history. I want to start by saying congratulations to all the graduates in the Cuba Rushford class of 2021. To all the proud parents, grandparents, families, and loved ones who join us today as we recognize all the hard work and accomplishments of our graduates. I acknowledge your contributions and offer you congratulations as well. For some of you, that meant being an alarm clock, others a teacher, and some a soundboard on difficult days. Well, today, you can bask in the first of many major accomplishments of your young adults. The last year and a half must have been hard to maneuver on a number of levels, ranging from sickness, isolation, and a new normal. But school has led to even more challenges. It is easy to remember the missed games, events, lost instructional time that left you frustrated, and time in the building to laugh with friends. Now you have come out on the other side and can truly tackle anything that might be you. I don't want to talk about the losses of the past year and a half, but instead I want to focus on what that has given us. For some, you have thrived with time management, responsibility, and appreciation for the simple things. 2 years ago, we would have chuckled at the concept of saying you forgot your mask, or by law, you can't gather in groups more than 10. Class of 2021, you have persevered through difficult times, and at some point, times will get hard again. But please reflect on everything you overcame to walk across the stage today. When creating your story, please do not skip the chapter titled COVID, but embrace a murder mystery prom, the ability to play six sports, online learning, and more time with family. You have a lot to be proud of, but the work is just beginning. Please take what you have learned and gone through to create the ending of your story. But remember, if you want a happy ending, that depends, of course, on where you stop your story. Continue to grow and build your perfect ending. And if you have learned anything, don't give up until you have achieved it. Good luck and God bless to the Cuba Rushford class.
Tonight, we are here to celebrate the incredible accomplishments of the class of 2021, a class who has endured a year and a half of a global pandemic, a class who was hopeful their senior year would be normal, but instead learned there is no normal. There is only an ever-changing new normal, and you will be much happier if you accept it for what it is. You made it, and you deserve this recognition, this honor, and these accolades. You've seen a lot in the past 2 years. A global pandemic, a nation of unrest, political turmoil, social justice movements, and personal events others may never know anything about. You may not quite believe it yet because you are living it, but you have witnessed and lived history. As the class of 2021, I'd like to share 21 life lessons with you, some a little lighter than others, some that may not resonate with you quite yet, some that we've learned as a result of circumstance, all I hope that mean something. One, embrace the unexpected. There's usually a silver lining to be found. Two, a genuine smile can be seen in your eyes, so smile, even when you're wearing a mask. Be social, but it doesn't have to be on social media. The Snapchat story isn't quite as meaningful as the real memory you're making. The Instagram heart isn't as genuine as a moment that makes your heart happy. And the TikTok laugh isn't as funny as the dance in real life. There's always time for an excuse, but excuses waste everyone's time. Do what you say you're going to do, and pay attention to the follow-through. Being silent about the wrong you see in the world makes you part of the problem. Stand up and speak up, but remember lesson number 6. Praise publicly and criticize privately. That counts on social media too. You'll get a lot further in life by having difficult yet respectful conversations. Banning conversations is not the way to respectful conversations. Allow people to talk, to have a voice, and to be heard. Even if their opinion is different from yours, it doesn't hurt to challenge your own thinking. Number 8, let June 2021 be the last time you simultaneously participate on Zoom while playing video games. Time management, prioritizing responsibilities, and being present, even online, are keys to success. Also, let June 2021 be the last time you sign on to Zoom in your pajamas and bedhead. The way you dress shows the level of respect you have for yourself and the work you're doing, even in the Zoom room. Number 10, give what you can, when you can, and remember, you get what you give. There's a lot in this life that costs money, but it costs nothing to exercise grace. Be gentle, be kind, be graceful. Be kind to yourself and be kind to others. Take care of your thoughts when you are alone, and take care of your words when you are with others. People come into your life for a reason, a season, or a lifetime. Recognize their worth, show them yours, and appreciate them all. When you are rejected by someone or something, remember that you are also being protected from them. The reframe is powerful. Number 15, you are incredible, but you are not invincible. Be careful. 16 is a lesson you've heard since you were little, but it's amazing how quickly we forget. Say thank you. Recognizing a gesture, acknowledging hard work, appreciating help, thank you goes a long way. I'm sorry carries weight and is much more important than words. I'm sorry, move to recognize the harm and make every effort not to repeat it. Be mindful in your apologies. 18, you deserve to be celebrated for all that you are. Whether that's something as big as walking across the stage for your diploma, being featured as Tweet of the Day on the Red Express Show, or even a silly birthday photo with your crazy principal. Someone's world changed the day you were born, and someone's world will forever be better because of you. What's next isn't always better, and it won't always be what others think it should be. Don't focus on what the next thing should be. Instead, live in the moment and love it. Life goes much faster than you think. Number 20, this will always be your home. You may not believe me now, but there is a sense of pride, belonging, and family you will always feel when you think back on your time at Cuba Rushford. And finally, to no surprise, I am sure, lesson number 21, be awesome. Families, your babies have become scholars. Students, tonight we end this chapter in your life with an exclamation point. Tomorrow is the first day of the rest of your life. Go forward with optimism, courage, strength, self-awareness, pride, and love. We're proud of you. We love you. We believe in you. Now get out there and make yourself
given up here from your colleagues, as well as the adults that have been part of your life. All those speeches are in a program that you can take and review in the future. Don't forget your program. There's a lot of good advice in there. So as you graduate and pursue your passions, remember you accomplished finishing the race, and we are very proud of you. I want to make sure I'm very targeted with my words. As people say, less is more. So this class, in the midst of the most difficult time in the world, chose to see the bright spots in the struggle and remind us that love, patience, kindness helps us through adversity. I want to thank you for choosing the road less traveled and knowing that sometimes you stand alone. My words of wisdom listed in order of importance. And by the way, these never change. I have three. Number one, seek wisdom and truth and have the courage to stand for it. Number two, your senior year was very unique and different. Use this experience to keep yourself flexible and nimble so that you can adapt and live a purposeful life. Number three, there's still complex problems to solve in our world. Remember, you are Cuba Rushford rebels. Now go solve them and make our communities a better place to live for future generations. We love you and wish you the best, and we will miss you. This time, we will be presenting diplomas to the 2021 graduates. Mr. Austin, can we turn on this?
Yes, it's on.
What does he want?
It's on. Right. It's on.
I can hear him. Is he on?
Is it music?
It's on.
It's on.
It's on.
It's on.
There we go.
Claire is the valedictorian for the class of 2021. She will be attending Duke University, where she will major in global health and biology. She is the recipient of the CR Ideal Student Award, Cuba American Legion Auxiliary English 12 Award, Cuba Rushford PTO Madeline Abraham Math Award, Cuba Friendship Masonic Lodge No. 306 Math 12 Awards, County of Cuba Auxiliary Post 2721 DFW History 12 Awards, Joseph W. and Inez A. Huck Scholarship, Kaylee Bourdais Scholar Upley Scholarship, and L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship. Haley is the salutatorian for the class of 2021. She will be attending Binghamton University, where she will be majoring in biomedical engineering. She is the recipient of the Cuba Friendship Masonic Lodge No. 306 Math 12 Awards, Town of Cuba Auxiliary to Post 2721 VFW History 12 Awards, a New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, and Joseph W. and Inez A. Huck Scholarship.
Desiree Faith Mins.
Desiree will be attending Jamestown Community College in the fall, where she will be majoring in liberal arts, math, and science. She is the recipient of the Walter F. and Louisa A. Sibley Scholarship, CRCS Student Council Leadership Award, L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship, and Renee M. Granger Nicholas Memorial Award.
Hunter Jacob Williams.
Hunter will be attending Alfred University in the fall, where he will play football. He plans to major in renewable energy engineering. He is the recipient of the CR Ideal Student Award, Character Council of Western New York Scholarship, Marlon Miller Engineering Award, Velva A. Wade Scholarship, American Legion Citizenship Award, Ralph Harbach Memorial Scholarship, Sons of the American Legion Award, Cuba Chamber of Commerce Scholarship, L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship, Cuba Rod and Gun Club Outdoor Enthusiast Scholarship, Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award, and an AU Scholar Award and AU Honors Award.
Jordan Keith Hollis.
Jordan will be attending SUNY Adirondack with a major in resource and environmental conservation. He is the recipient of the Joseph W. and Inez Huck Scholarship, Carl and Lois Farner Award, and SUNY Adirondack Foundation Scholarship.
Logan Matthew Barber.
Logan will be attending Alfred State in the fall for welding. He is the recipient of the Donald and Jean Totten Flicken Paul Amundsen Memorial Scholarship, Richard L. Reynolds Memorial Scholarship, Cuba Lions Club Tech Vocational Award, Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award, and Cuba Rod and Gun Club Trap Team Scholarship.
Eliana Faith Barnes.
Eliana will be attending the University of New Haven. She will be majoring in political science through the dual degree and honors program. She is the recipient of the Cuba Rushford Alumni Association Scholarship, Cuba Historical Society Florence Wills Memorial History Award, New Haven Presidential Scholarship, and New Haven Honors Program Scholarship.
Beeman.
Jordan will be attending Jamestown Community College with a major in veterinary science and biology. She is the recipient of the L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship.
Leah Elizabeth Fuller.
Leah will be attending Penn State University, majoring in advertising and public relations. She is the recipient of the Walter F. and Louisa A. Sibley Scholarship, Jessica Karst Pauley Memorial Award, Allegheny County Counselors Association Scholarship, Patriot Newspaper English 12 Composition Award, and Penn State Provost Award.
Catherine Goble.
Natalie will be attending SUNY Fredonia. She will major in communication disorders and sciences. She is the recipient of the Renee Wolver Memorial Scholarship and the Fredonia Scholar Award.
Caden Granger.
Caden will be attending the University of Pittsburgh at Bradford this fall. He will major in math education and computer engineering. He is the recipient of the Cuba Rushford Alumni Association Scholarship, Brenda Feely Memorial Scholarship, Joseph W. and Inez A. Help Scholarship, Carl and Lois Farner Award, and Jeffrey L. Linza Memorial Scholarship.
Hunter Gracelyn Yonke.
Hunter will be attending SUNY Geneseo in the fall, majoring in business. She is the recipient of the Diane Winchell Gordon Memorial Award.
Aiden DeVay Kellogg.
Aiden will be attending Alfred State College and majoring in business administration. She is the recipient of the Student Trust Company Annual Scholarship, Joseph W. and Inez A. Hub Scholarship, L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship, and Alfred State Scholars Award.
Aaron David Kumpf.
Aaron will be attending the New York Institute of Technology in New York City. He will be working towards his Bachelor of Architecture and Design. He is the recipient of a Belva A. Waite Scholarship and the L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship. Autumn will be attending Alfred State, majoring in nursing. She is the recipient of the Ann Swift Memorial Scholarship, William D. and Catherine Griffin Fraser Award, New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, and Cuba Lions Club Nursing Award. Lauren will be attending Alfred State. She'll be majoring in interior design. She's the recipient of the Joseph W. and Inez A. Hub Scholarship, L. Ted Utter Family Scholarship, Lawrence Dye Incorporated Scholarship, Robert Paul Memorial Music Award, and an Alfred State Pioneer Award.
Cameron Scott Shaw.
Cameron will be entering the workforce. She plans to work with children. Adrian will be attending Rochester Institute of Technology. He will be majoring in computing security. He is the recipient of the Joseph W. and Inez Hay Hawk Scholarship, PTO Scholarship, New York State Scholarship for Academic Excellence, LTED Utter Family Scholarship, and an RIT Presidential Scholarship.
Well done. Emily Paginski.
Emily will be attending Niagara County Community College with a major in baking and pastry arts. Joining the workforce after graduation.
Ethan Bump.
Ethan will be attending Alfred State this fall. He will be majoring in electrical technician and maintenance. He is the recipient of the Carl and Lois Farner Award, Cuba Grange No. 799 Agricultural Awards, Bella Waite Scholarship, Andrew Beck Memorial Scholarship, Elko Credit Union John Patterson Memorial Scholarship, and an Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award.
Nathan Burdick.
Nate joined the Army. He will be a private first-class military police officer. He is the recipient of the Cuba Historical Society Florence Wills Memorial History Award, Sons of Ben Betts Award, Dale McGinnis Scholarship, and an Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award.
Clayton Burgesson.
Clayton will be joining the workforce. He plans to work as a mechanic at Kendall Karn Automotive. He is the recipient of the Allegheny County Pomona Grange No. 45 Perseverance Award.
Trent Joseph Chamberlain.
Trent will be attending lineman school in Georgia and joining the workforce.
Joshua Ethan Claus.
Josh joined the. He will be infantry. He is the recipient of the Sons of the Ambats Award. Yeah.
Christopher Dibler.
Sean will be joining the workforce. He will work at the heavy equipment field as an operator. He is the recipient of the Allegheny County Pomona Grange No. 45 Inspiration Award.
Cameron Dunlap.
Cameron will be attending Alfred State. He will be majoring in heavy equipment operation. He is the recipient of the Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award.
Way to go, Cam!
Jacob Dutton.
Jacob plans to attend college to become an auto mechanic. To attend Jamestown Community College, majoring in physical education studies.
Put down in front of you, we'll catch you.
Holden James Bajeski.
Holden plans to join the workforce as a welder with ARG in Pennsylvania.
Mom, you have to wait until you talk. Mom, no screaming until she's off the stage. Okay.
Let's do it.
Eric, get your house in.
Break the rule.
Eric plans to attend the electrician program at Alfred State in the fall. He is the recipient of the Cuba Friendship Masonic Lodge No. 306 Net 12 Awards, Trails End Scholarship, and an Alfred State Pioneer Award.
Randy Lynn Green.
Randy plans to join the workforce.
He just embarrassed her. Oh, she's so embarrassed.
Way to go, Brandy! We love you!
She gonna beat you?
I told her she was gonna kill
you. You guys better stay up for 24 days.
She's like, oh, dang it. You guys are sleeping outside. Oh, he's great. Oh.
Quint will be joining the Air Force. He is the recipient of the American Legion Good Citizenship Award. Honorable mention. Trevor will be joining the workforce to involve him in auto body repairs. He is the recipient of the Stephen Holmes and Gillette Memorial Agricultural Award and the Cuba Grange No. 799 Agricultural Award.
Cole Herrick.
Cole will be attending SUNY Oswego. He'll be majoring in elementary education with a focus in science. The recipient of the Alfred Wood Scholarship, Lawrence Dye Incorporated Scholarship, Russell Rand Al Milton Scholarship, CRTAA Education Award, and SUNY Oswego Scholarship. Courtney will be attending Jamestown Community College, where she will be majoring in nursing. Enlisting in the Navy.
Riley Noel Jennings.
Riley will be taking a year off to travel. She will also be joining the workforce and plans to attend trade school. Recipient of the Barbie Levy Scholarship. Production. She is the recipient of a Chess Spear Memorial Visual Arts Award, French Club Service Award, and an L. Ted Otter Family Scholarship.
You don't want to mess with her.
Connor Cutts. Connor will be joining the workforce. He's accepted an apprenticeship with the local 158 Operators Union. He is the recipient of the Charles and Cecilia R. Stoker Memorial Award, Dale McGinnis Scholarship, and the Dear Sweet Memorial Award, Cloutier's USBC Bowling Association Scholarship, and an Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award. Resource Conservation and Management. He is the recipient of the Cuba Branch No. 799 Agriculture and the Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award.
Alexis Catherine Slegs.
Alexis will be attending Jamestown Community College in collaboration with St. Bonaventure University. She will be majoring in physiology.
Alexa Swimline.
Alexa will be attending Jamestown Community College, where she will be majoring in criminal justice and psychology.
Alexander Walt Persley.
Alex will be attending Alfred State College in the fall, majoring in electrical engineering. He is the recipient of the Belvoir White Memorial Scholarship, Sidney and Janice Jean Bump Industrial Arts Award, and an Alfred State Scholars Award. Attending Indiana Wesleyan University, where he'll be majoring in business finance. He is the recipient of the Cuba Council of Churches Scholarship, Cuba Chamber of Commerce Scholarship, and IWU Academic Achievement Scholarship.
Landon Robert White.
Ha ha ha!
Brandon will be attending Jamestown Community College, where he'll be majoring in criminal justice. He is the recipient of the Go Beyond New York State Dale McGinnis Scholarship, LSAT Honor Family Scholarship, Patriot Newspaper Journalism Award, and an Alexander K. Radloff Memorial Award. Wyatt will be attending Alfred State College, where he will be majoring in electrical engineering.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2021.
Just grab that. Sleep well, sir.
I was asking about four tents for next week.
Yes.
And then